विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे
महात्मा गांधी की 150वीं जयंती केवल भारत ही नहीं बल्कि पूरे विश्व के लिए उनके आदर्शों को गहराई से समझने अपनाने और अमल में लाने का अवसर है। A few weeks after Gandhiji's birthday, on November 26, we will mark the 70th anniversary of the adoption of our constitution. This enlightened and far-reaching document laid the foundations of our republic. It was the work of men and women of principle and patriotism. The members of the Constituent Assembly, in particular, we recall the role of Baba Sahib, Dr. Bhim Rao, Dr. Ambedkar, who chaired the drafting committee. In his honor and in our Constitution's honor, the nation will celebrate Constitution's Day this year in an appropriate manner. This year, the people of India, each one of us, have another responsibility of voting in the general election and electing the 17th Lok Sabha. The ideas and idealism of our democracy will come into full force. Once more, as we do every 5 years, voters will deliver their verdict and write their destiny. This year's election will be the first when voters born in the 21st century will contribute to electing a new Lok Sabha. यह चुनाव सभी देशवासियों के लिए लोकतंत्र में अपनी सक्रिय भागीदारी निभाने का एक महत्वपूर्ण अवसर है। चुनाव के समय हम सब साझेदारी और समानता पर आधारित समाज की आशाओं और आकांक्षाओं के लिए अपनी प्रतिबद्धता को दोहराते हैं। हमारे लोकतंत्र की सफलता के लिए मतदान करना हमारा एक पुनीत कर्तव्य बन जाता है। मेरा आप सभी से अनुरोध है कि इस कर्तव्य का अवश्य पालन करें। Having said that, let us remember that this election is only a milestone in the journey towards fulfilling the aspirations of our people and building a developed India. India is at the doorstep of eliminating extreme poverty for the first time in memory. A program of universal and equitable healthcare has begun to be rolled out. Affordable medicines and medical devices and implants are becoming a reality for more and more sections of our people. A greater number of Indians than ever previously have access to proper housing with modern sanitation and electricity. Leapfrogging technologies and leapfrogging enlightenment are empowering our farmers and equipping our soldiers. They are enabling our traditionally deprived fellow citizens and educating our daughters and our sons. They are exciting the entrepreneurial energies and the infectious startup culture that has made our younger generation and our India the focus of world attention and admiration. In exactly 6 weeks from today, I would be completing 3 years as the Consul General of India in Toronto. This time has been a great learning experience. The initiatives that I took right at the inception of my tenure have not only continued during all these 3 years, but have also borne results and created positivity and goodwill for the consulate.
Indian Republic Day and 150th birthday of Gandhiji. It's a very, very important turning point for the history of India. If we see the history, this is the day when the foundation for the constitution, future constitution of India, were laid upon. So it's a very, very celebrating day for all the Indian heritage people around the world. What is your message, since we are celebrating 150th birthday of Gandhiji also, and it's a Republic Day, so it's a very special year today for India. What do you see, and what is your message for all the communities?
Well, The President of India himself has made a mention of this last night in his message to the nation, that we are going to celebrate 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi this year, and also today we are celebrating 70th Republic Day of India. Well, this is a very important occasion. I think Gandhiji's teachings and his message should be spread around the world, because he talked about uniting not only India but also the entire world in the spirit of Vasudev Kutumbakam. India has its own place in the world, and we have our own sort of foreign policy which has stood us apart from the rest of the nations in the world. India, you should expect the best possible. India is on the path of progress. Today we are about to take over as the sixth largest economy in the world, and I think it's very important that we also take note of the Indians around the world who are spread all around the world. They are there in every country, and they are contributing immensely to the progress and development of every other nation as being residents and nationals of those countries, and also they are creating goodwill and great relationship between those countries and India.
It is the 150th anniversary of Bapu. I would like to say that we must remember, and Indians, wherever we go, wherever we create a house, a home in other countries, we spread this message of Vaishnav Janato Tene Kahiye, Preet Parai Janire. We are compassionate people. We try to merge into the culture and the value system while keeping our own value system wherever we go, and that is why we stand apart as the diplomats of peace wherever we go.
First of all, thank you, TAG TV. The head office is in my riding, so we're proud of that. TAG TV, we're proud of our riding as well. Talking about Republic Day, 70th Republic Day, you know, the world is run on democracy, and the biggest democracy is India, so that's what we're celebrating here today. And I wish and I hope we not just have a democracy, we live up to a true democracy where people use and exercise their right. And I just came back from India, I just not even a week back, and that's the message I actually gave there as well. Let's not forget, it is the people who have the power.
So Nina, what is your message on this occasion?
Well, I think it's very wonderful. First of all, I'd like to thank everybody from TAG TV for listening in and being here today and joining us, and the invitation of the Consul General of India. We're here to celebrate India's Republic Day, a very significant and important day in India's history. And, you know, I think it was wonderful today. We also witnessed the Hindi Writers Guild, who came and donated $4,001 for the martyrs of India, for those people who've lost their lives protecting India and looking after India. But I'm very proud to be Canadian, but I'm also proud to be of Indian heritage, and to be able to be here with so many wonderful people and celebrate this day, and to be here, I'd like to thank the Consul General, his lovely wife Seema, and all the people that came and joined us. And thank you to you for always being part of this and teaching us about India's heritage as well.
We are here to celebrate the Republic Day. Today's 17th Republic Day celebration is going on in India. It is a very important day for India, because we had been taking part for many, many years. As an incumbent, as Air Force personnel, I used to be part of this many places. So same way, when we came here, when we come here to celebrate with the Indian consulate, we feel really proud of that how we are collaborating between India and Canada. Because Canada and India relationships are very important for ourselves, for our Canadian middle class, and for the Indian middle class, because we have very common thing to share with each other.
Republic Day, and we have two people who are going to talk about what they have to say about today. Hi.
Hindi Writers Guild, they held a program, Bharat Mata Ko Pranam, and on that we collected some donation for contributing to Bharat Ke Veer, our naujawan jo ke desh ke liye apni jaan dete hain, hamari raksha karte hain, aur hum sab ko unko pranam karte hain. Ye ek chhota si bhet hamari or se hai, swikar kijiye.
आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे विद्या जी इस बारे में?
देखिए, आज गणतंत्र दिवस के समारोह पे मैं सारे भारतवासियों को हाथ जोड़ के प्रणाम करता हूं और उनके बधाई देता हूं। और साथ में ये जो इनिशिएटिव अक्षय कुमार जी जो हमारे एक माइनाज एक्टर हैं उन्होंने एक इनिशिएटिव स्टार्ट किया था भारत के वीर, तो सारे भारतवासी जहां कहीं पे भी हैं, मूल रूप से भारतीय हैं या कहीं और रहते हैं, तो दे कैन रेज फंड्स फॉर द स्लेन एंड मार्टियर्ड सोल्जर्स ऑफ आवर कंट्री। तो हमें बड़ी खुशी हो रही है कि हमने जम्मू कश्मीर का एक म्यूज़िकल नाइट ऑर्गेनाइज़ किया था लास्ट ईयर जुलाई में एंड वी रेज सम फंड्स, और मुझे बहुत ही खुशी हो रही है कि हम अपने वीरों के लिए, हम उनका कर्ज कभी उतार नहीं सकते, जब वो गुफाओं में, रेगिस्तानों में और सियाचिन के ग्लेशियर्स में दिन रात हमारे लिए, हमारी रक्षा करते और हमारे घरों में आराम से सोते हैं, तो उनके लिए तो हम उनका कर्ज हम कभी उतार नहीं पाएंगे। पर ये एक छोटी सी चेष्टा है और मैं चाहता हूँ कि ये ऐसी चेष्टा सारी दुनिया के लोग करें और हमारे हिंदुस्तान में लोग करें, हमारे जितने भी भारतीय डायस्पोरा के लोग बाकी मुल्कों में हैं वो भारत के वीर के लिए जितना भी वो कर सकते हैं वो करें, यही हमारी है प्रार्थना है। और मैं एक बारी फिर शत शत नमन करता हूँ हमारे भारत के वीरों को कि जिनकी बलिदानों की वजह से हम अपने घरों में चैन से सोते हैं। जय हिंद, जय भारत।
विपिन शर्मा, शहीदों की चिताओं पर लगेंगे हर बरस मेले, शहीदों की चिताओं पर लगेंगे हर बरस मेले, वतन पे मिटने वालों का यही बाकी निशान होगा। आज 70वें गणतंत्रवाद दिवस पर मैं अपनी तरफ से, पार्टी की तरफ से, जितने भी देशवासी हैं, विदेशों में बसे हुए हैं, भारत में बसे हुए हैं, सबको लख लख बधाई देता हूं। और मेरा ये कहना है कि वो कौमें हमेशा नष्ट हो जाया करती हैं, वो समाज नष्ट हो जाया करते हैं जो अपने शहीदों को भूल जाते हैं। आज का दिन शहीदों को नमन करने का दिन है, उनको याद करने का दिन है। सो आज हम सभी लोग एकत्रित होकर 70वां गणतंत्रता दिवस जो कॉन्सुलेट ऑफिस टोरंटो में मना रहे हैं, लोग अलग अलग स्टेटों से सज धज कर बहुत ही उत्साह के साथ एकत्रित होकर कॉन्सुलेट ऑफिस में आज जो खुशी का पर्व मना रहे हैं, मैं अपनी तरफ से बहुत बहुत बधाई देता हूँ। भारत माता की जय। वंदे मातरम।